गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप एवरी वन इज फाइन। कैन यू टेल द नेम्स ऑफ प्लैनेट्स? ओके, द 8 प्लैनेट्स आर मर्क्यूरी, वीनस, अर्थ, मार्स, जुपिटर, सैटर्न, यूरेनस एंड नेपच्यून। ओके, वेयर वी आर लिविंग? We live on planet Earth. Good. Okay. Today our topic is Know Your Planet. What is today's topic? Know Your Planet. Okay. Then first, before going to start lesson, once listen, Anna. Globe. What is a globe? Globe is a model to study the Earth. Yes, globe is a model to study the earth. It represents correct shapes, size and location of continents and oceans and so on. Though accurate, it is difficult to carry and cannot be used to represent details of a place or only a part of the earth. Only one half of the earth can be seen at a time on a globe. The shape of the earth as a sphere. Okay, children, the shape of the earth as a sphere. Next, come to the point, maps. What is a map? What is a map? A map is a representation of the earth or a part of it on a flat surface. It can represent a part of the earth with more details. The whole earth can be seen at a time. A collection of a map is called an atlas. What is atlas? A collection of maps. A collection of maps is called an atlas. Since the earth is spherical, a map cannot actually represent the earth. Okay, children, next come to the point. Different types of maps. Okay, there are different types of maps used to represent different aspects. First one is physical maps, next political maps, third one climatic maps and so on. Okay, first reading maps. Okay, what is reading maps? Maps follow a system of directions. There are 4 major directions and 4 intermediate directions. The top of the map is always north, marked by an arrow of N. The bottom of the map is south, right of the map is east, and the left of the map is west. The 4 intermediate directions are northeast, northwest, southeast, and southwest. Okay, next come to the point. Scaling. Every map used a scale to represent the actual distance or size by a smaller unit. This ratio between the distance on the ground and on the map is called the scale of the map. Once again, listen carefully, children. Every map uses a scale to represent the actual distance or size by a smaller unit. Okay. This ratio between the distance and on the maps is called the scale of the map. For example, distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. It is not possible to show these cities at 200 kilometers from each other on the map. Is it right? Yes. Therefore, this distance is represented by a smaller unit. The ratio between the distance on the ground and the distance on the map is known as the scale of the map. In this case, we would write it as 5 cm 200 kilometers. Maps are always drawn to scale. Okay, children? Next, colors. For example, on a physical map, water bodies are shown in shades of blue. Light blue is used for shallow waters and darker shade of the blue for deep waters. Plain or lowlands are shown in shades of green. Highlands are shown in shades of brown. Okay, children, understand? Few important points for you. Once again, listen carefully. Ferdinand Magellan first sailed around the world and proved that the earth is round. Pictures taken from the space have also proved that the earth is like a sphere. A globe shows the distance of the land and water on the surface of the earth. The correct shape, size, and location of continents and oceans on the earth can also be seen on a globe. Maps are drawn on the flat surfaces. We can show continents, countries, cities, and neighborhoods on a map. They give us a lot of information about a country or a place. Maps cannot be used to show the spherical earth because curved surface cannot be shown accurately on a flat surface. That's why a map is less accurate than a globe. The four features which help us to read a map are directions, scale, symbols, and colors. Okay, children? Thank you, children.